3편 보여드리겠습니다. 짤막한 동영상인데.
We're going to watch a short video clip.
여러분 이거 기억하시죠?
You remember this one?
네. 우리의 마음이 인공적인
mind and magnetic therapy. Our mind can be controlled by artificial magnetic force. Remember Benny Hinn? The electric wave from his hand? That wave can be stored in the machine, and that machine itself can heal the patients.
뇌파에 대한 여러분의 그 인식을 좀 강력하게 심어드리기 위해서
To help you to understand specifically or better, I want to show you this video clip. You know, our mind can control everything. Now this one, this person is paralyzed. His hands, his arms are all paralyzed. This person, can this person use the computer? Now we gather this brain waves, it's connected, right? And this person is going to move this cursor on the computer. Now we can do that. We are living in that state of technology. Now we're going to have this brain waves of this monkey using his brain waves. Can this monkey also move the machinery, their function, the machinery? We have this experiment, the picture here, the first scene. There's a monkey. You see the wire in the back of the machine. That wire is gathering the monkey's brain waves. And here, this is the machine, the two fingers with the machine. And the scientist now is giving the piece of bananas at the end of this machine's finger. And then, of course, this monkey is fixed. Its arms and legs are all fixed. So the monkey cannot use his hands or the body, legs. Okay, you see, its hands, its head, its legs, they're all fixed. It can't move. But because of this machine wire, it's connecting the monkey's brain wave. So the monkey can eat this banana only by his thinking. This is a video clip about this. You see this video clip. Now watch this. He wants to eat this banana, so he's thinking. So he conveys his brain waves to this machine, and this machine, the finger, you know, gives him food. Wherever the banana is there, the machine, this finger, gets the banana and then gives it to the monkey. See, the scientist is changing his position, but then wherever it is, the machine fingers, it catches the bananas and gives it to the monkey. Okay, that was the video clip that we just watched. Yeah, so when we open our minds and when we connect to the Spirit of God, then yes, His will be done through us and in us. It doesn't mean that our free will is confided, but we obey God with our free will. We choose to obey God. So it's our choice as well. So we human beings are not robots because we have free wills.
인간이 어떻게 기억을 하는가?
Now, how can we remember? How can human beings remember?
과학자들 간에 아주 그 심각한 질문이었습니다.
It was a quite critical question among scientists. Where can human beings save this memory?
미국에 유길박 장로라는 분이 있는데 그분이 그
스탠포드에서 one elder in America. He studied computer in UCLA Stanford. UCLA and Stanford. He said somehow somewhere in our brain there is this system to memorize. Scientists is searching, where is that? And me, I was thinking, maybe it's not saved in the brain, but then each neuron,
어떤 기억, 어떤 이벤트, 어떤 그런 사건 혹은 어떤 장소, 뭐 이런 여러 가지들을 기억하는 웹 메모리라고 그러나요? 네. 그 컴퓨터 자체에는 데이터가 없고.
You know, web memory, computer itself, it has no data.
네. 웹 하드에.
But it is in the heart.
그것이 그게 필요할 때마다.
But whenever is needed, the information.
컴퓨터에 와서 기억이 나는 것이다. 그럼 그 웹 하드의 역할은 누가 하는?
Is brought up. Then I say, who is doing that web memory? I think that is what the angels are doing. That's my point of view. That can be very quite controversial in science. You know, we have conscious and subconscious.
무의식이라는 것은 뭐냐?
What is subconscious? Sigmund Freud talked about our subconscious.
무의식이라는 것이 그게 의식이 없는 것이 아니라.
Subconscious doesn't mean that it's out of conscious, but there must be something else in subconscious.
많은 기억들이 저장이 돼.
So a lot of things are saved or stored in the subconscious. That's what the Freud said. So because of that subconscious, some kind of mental or psychological problems can occur because of that memory. You know, to measure this, our brain or the function of the brain, the technology has improved, it developed recently. Back in old time, they say, if they have general anesthesia, they thought the brain, the function of the brain stopped because they freeze their conscious. But then they found this amazing fact that even though they have general anesthesia, the function of brain is still on, and even though you're sleeping, the function of the brain is still on. So the scientists, they got very curious about that. So they say, let's say when we're awake, we have conscious 100%. Then they wonder how much of percent is left when you don't work. So they measure this. Do you know how much percent is left? When your conscience, when there is no conscience, like when you're asleep or when you're anesthetized, can you guess how much percent of conscience is left? I mean, when the conscience is left, do you know how much of functioning, how much of brain, how much does the brain function? Now, 95%. Is left. So when we're awake, our conscious works only the 5%. You know, when we are out of conscious, our brain still works. 95%. We have 100%, you know, general we're anesthetized generally. But still, the brain is working. You know, T cell goes to this part and that part and destroys the bad cells. You know, in our subconscious, God is still working in our subconscious. I think if this technology is developed more and more, I think this 5% I say will be reduced. I think the subconscious will be increased more than 95%. I think maybe 99%, maybe 99.99999%, things like that. So in conclusion, God is doing most of the part. With our conscience, what we're doing is very, very little. So you know, subconscious is like amazing. This is Science News. Science News magazine in America, established 1999. It was published. This article is published 1999. Now the scientists found out this. You know, let's say somebody, you know, goes backwards and that, you know, quietly, and that person wants to surprise someone. And let's say this woman got this hunch feeling and something is behind me, and that person goes around and it's like, hey. So, in conscious, you didn't know, but in subconscious, somehow you have this feeling. We call this hunch feeling. We experience these things in our normal life. Is that the true? Does this exist scientifically? So that's what the scientists searched. Let's look at this material, this clip. You know, this one, this picture. This is dynamic red line you see demonstrates, according to the parapsychologist Dean. You know, there's a person, and that person is right before the screen. And this person sees the beautiful landscape. And then this person sees the terrible car accidents. So this one changes in turn. This person never knows what kind of picture this person will see. Randomly, the pictures are shown to this person, beautiful and terrible. Anyways, this person saw all these pictures. So this person get excited or horrified and excited and horrified. And then now they change the order of the pictures. And they install this experimental things on their fingertips. That's minus 1 second. That's 0 point and minus 1 second. The screen is going to be shown to this person at the 0 point. When the terrible picture is shown, then this person's bloodstream increased. Yeah, when this person saw this picture on the zero line, then the blood stream increases. But when this person sees the beautiful scenes, the blood stream doesn't get increased. The point is right before this person sees the terrible picture, 3 or 4 seconds before even this person sees, the blood stream increases. It means like this person feels like maybe next time the picture is going to be very terrible. And then, of course, when this person sees, then the blood stream increases. But the beautiful pictures are shown, then the bloodstream doesn't flow. But then, however, this person doesn't know what's happening inside in this person's body. So the scientists say expectancy wave. Expectancy wave is like, you know, this person already watched the terrible scenes, right? So this person, we said though, they mixed the pictures, so they don't know which and when those terrible pictures are going to be shown, but somehow these people, the person, could feel. Okay, who knows which picture is going to be terrible? Only the spirit of God, spirit of the evil, you know, only the spirit knows which picture is going to be shown. If the spirit says, next picture is going to be terrible, and then that person have this hunch feeling that next picture is going to be terrible. So not to shock us too bad, there is some kind of spirit to prepare us not to be so shocked. That's how we explain this picture. Minds may track danger unconsciously. That's the title of this article.
Expectancy wave라는 말이 나오죠. 그렇죠?
Distinct slow wave brain activity emerged about half a second before the time at which shocks had been delivered and the conditioning phase.
아주 끔찍한 그림을 볼 때마다
It means whenever you see the terrible pictures, let's say, you know, whenever you see these terrible pictures, you have this electric shock installment on the fingertip, you know, there. So whenever you see the picture, you get this electric shock, okay, from the installment. So now your brain is orientated that whenever you see the terrible picture, you get this shock. Now, if they show you like terrible pictures, like 0.1 second time, then you know we don't recognize the terrible picture. That's the subliminal. Our 5% of conscious didn't recognize the picture because it, you know, passed so quickly. Because it passed so fast, you didn't know that was a terrible picture. Or bloodstream sometimes increase. That's the spiritual thing is working. You know, even though we don't see these terrible pictures, but our bloodstream increased and our brainwave increased, why is that? Here, distinct slow wave brain activity emerged about half a second before the time at which shocks had been delivered in the conditioning phase before the 0.1 seconds. In our subliminal conscious, the phase, the purpose of this experiment is for this women. You know, sometimes this woman says, you know, honey, I don't know why, but suddenly I felt strange and I felt afraid. Where does this come from? Medically, we cannot explain this. Sigmund Freud said there is subconscious, there is something very complicated, and from your subconscious, it comes to your conscious. That's how he explained. You know, we sense the spiritual level, right? So we know that kind of fear comes from the evil waves in our subconscious. So you sometimes say like, oh, I don't know why, but there, I feel this hunch feeling. Consciously, this person doesn't know why, but you know, it works in the subconscious, but that subconscious was controlled by the evil spirit. We know now is because, you know, those things happen because of the activity from the spiritual level of activity. Let's define this in a simple way. Let's define this spiritual activity in a simple way. Newsweek, year 2008, November 12th, just about a year ago, that was established in the Newsweek. Can we solve this puzzle of memory? This puzzle can be solved?
California, UCLA,
in America, UCLA University, Itzhak Fried, Professor Itzhak Fried, they showed Seinfeld, Simpsons, you know, that short video or the movies with the 13 people. Let's say I'm a very popular neurologist. I wanted to know how this memory works. So I show this picture of this building, and I show this picture of that building and the other building. So I, you know, took those three buildings, picture of those three buildings. I took those pictures of three buildings, and I show the patients that this building is this, and that building is this, and this building is this. So I explained. So I told the patients to remember these buildings and the name of the building. When I explain this building, you know, one of the neurons, okay, in your brain, you know, blinks. You know, why? Because that means that neuron remembers this building. When I explain other building, that other neuron blinks, you know, it means that neuron is in charge of remembering this building and that building and other buildings. So now when I explain three buildings, three different neurons got blinked. So now I realize that which neuron is responsible for memorizing which building. Because I saw which neuron blinked. So I told this patient, you know, I showed you three buildings, right? Please think of any buildings that you want to think. Then this person, and then this person remembers this building, let's say. And then that neuron that is connected to this building is blinking. Is it after I spoke or before I spoke? This is the that building. Do you know when this neuron blinks? Yes, before you even speak, this neuron blinks. You know, this person was told to remember the building and the name, but it wasn't this person, but the spirit wave. But it was the spirit wave which touches this neuron, and then that neuron is blinking, and then now you remember this building. You know, you don't know which neuron's blinking. You know, researchers, they could tell which building this person is going to remember. Why? Because that, you know, the scientists, they knew which neuron is connected to this building and that building and the other building. So when the neurons blinked, they knew this person is going to remember that building. That's what it means. So it's not the person who remembers the name and the building, but it's the spirit outside. That's the brainwave, calm brainwave, calm, very calm. You know, this person was told to remember something, and this person said, when this person said, when he started to think, the brain waves were increased. And when this person says from and when the brain waves reached the peak, the top, do you know how long did it take? 2-3 seconds. Two, 3 seconds ahead, brain waves got increased. And then this person could say, I remember this building and the name. So here we interpret this experiment in a spiritual level. That how can we interpret this? So when we say when we remember something, it means which, you know, the spirit wave touches this neuron and that neuron. You know, that spirit decides which to remember. So that we remember. If we don't agree on this, you know, scientists are very amazed because when they saw the result of the experiment, the scientists are very shocked on the result of the experiment. Do you know what they say? I'll show you. They said, that's 2008 October, Science Magazine. Science Magazine, 2008 October. Itzhak Fried, okay, he says here. See, this is the title of the reports. Internally generated reactivation of single neurons in human hippocampus during free recall. A free recall, right? Whatever you want to remember, that one is a free recall. During free recall, internally generated reactivation of single neurons in human hippocampus. You know that single neuron? Reactivated. Here, reactivate means like the blinking that when I use the word blink, it means reactivated. Internally generated reactivation of single neurons during free recall. They say there is something internally generated reactivation. That means by itself. So scientists, you know, express this internally generated reactivation of single neurons during free recall. They say they're doing it by itself. Internally generated what? Energy. There must be energy to be activated. They call this report in this way. This is the abstract. They say, we suggest that this reactivation this amazing reactivation is an internally generated neuronal correlate. Internally generated neuronal correlate. It's like that by itself they're doing it. That's their suggestion. And that doesn't make sense if you speak strictly. When you accept the spiritual level and the spiritual level, then this makes sense. But then if there is no God, no spiritual, if they don't accept the spiritual thing, they can only say in this way, internally generated. But you know, there must be outer side of influence to generate something. There can't be internal something. Because we understand in this way, internally generated, that's why you feel like, you say, I feel like doing this, I don't feel like doing that. You're educated to be separated from God. Even though God showed you that He exists, but then we interpret in this way, internally generated, we reject that there is God. We reject the existence of God. You know, God controls every genes in our body through the spirit wave. We don't know what we want, even. We need to study the Word of God so that He can, you know, work on us without even though we don't know what we want, God can do everything in our subconscious. So we need to study the Word of God. So then, you know, God is working in our subconscious, right? 95% so far, you know? So we should study the Word of God. If we take those bad or worldly or satanic thinking in us, then our subconscious, there's all the trouble only. When those bad things or evil things grow in us, I can tell that, you know, remember in Genesis, in Noah's time, the sin, the evil things were all over the world. That's what it means. 95% of my subconscious is all controlled by evil spirit. Then God's power cannot be with me. God cannot be with me. And that's the moment when the judgment arrives. When we say the cup is overflowed with sin, that's what it means. When we say our cup is filled with sin or iniquity, it's not just literature, but this is scientifically correct as well. Only God knows that where my cup is right now. As we learn the truth of God, when we learn the Word of God, when we learn the love of God, we should get those evil spirit in our subconscious. We should pray and repent, and we need to cleanse those iniquities and transgressions in our subconscious. We need to push those evil spirit away in us so that our heart, our subconscious is filled with the true spirit of God. Let us pray. Loving Lord, Father, science is developing. And right now, they are right there under the spiritual level of understanding. So they make all these different forms of therapies, mind and magnetic therapy, and they want to control the life by their hands or in their hands. Father, we see these kind of evil working in the holy place. Father, even some church, Sunday churches there, they say this false spirit is the blessings of God, and this false spirit is working in every church in this world, and a lot of things are happening, and people are amazed, and they're fooled by this false spirit. Please, Father, we are waiting for your true spirit in our Remnant Church. Please give us your spirit and enlighten us with the spirit so that we will be awake. Please, Father, fill your true spirit in us, so that when the latter rain comes, we want to be used as your tool to save so many people. Please, we want to be ready. Help us. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.